In this video, we're going to be looking at how to edit points inside Houdini. I just want to take a moment here to mention that this model was generated using the Make Human app, which you can download at makehuman.org. Okay, let's continue, and we're going to collapse the timeline since we won't need it for this example. Select the head and hit the 2 key for points. Let's say we want to give him a bigger hair. Currently, we're in the front view, so hit the spacebar and 1 key to get into perspective view. You can see that none of the points in the back are selected. Let's jump back to the front view and reselect. And let's just turn off Select Visible Geometry only and then click on the Lasso Select. Jump back to perspective view, and you can see that we have the points in the back selected. Hit the Enter or T key, and we'll just move the points upwards with the middle mouse click and drag. A teensy bit more, and we can use the Soft Edit Radius slider. This helps to ease the transition of the surface. Okay, that's probably a bit too big, so let's tone it down a bit. That's better. Okay, so now let's give him puffier cheeks. Select a point on his cheek, and in the edit mode, which is already selected, scroll down and click on Use Mirror. Whoops! We have the soft edit radius turned to the max. Set it back to 0. Now you can see that the points are moving in object space, but we want them to move along the normal. Just undo that, and right mouse button click over the handle, and go to Align Handle, and you can see we have a few options, which we can access by pressing the M key. Hit the M key and cycle through until we are in component mode. And we'll turn back down soft edit radius. Now let's look at a shirt collar. Select a point and hold down A and middle mouse button click to select a ring of points. Hit the T key and hit the M key until we get to World Align mode. Whoa, that was all weird because we have Use Mirror and Soft Edit Radius turned on. Let's turn them off. So now if we try to position the collar, we are limited and can only move it up and down or sideways, which isn't what we want. What we can do is right mouse button over the handle and select Toggle Peak Handle. And now our points are all moving along their respective normals. Next up, we're going to look at how we can smooth and shape our surface using a sculpt brush. Hit the N key to select all the points and hit the Enter key. Now right mouse button and select Brush Handle. Note, if you don't see the brush cursor, hit the B key. Let's right mouse button and select Deform and Smooth. Let's turn on Points Display so that we can better see our surface. Well, that surface is pretty bad here, so let's smooth it out. We're just going to turn on the opacity values so that it's not so strong. And hold down Shift and left mouse button click and drag to resize the brush. Hey, look at this piece of shirt here sticking out. Let's click on the point and tuck it back in. You can hit the S key and then click on the point. Hit the T key, and if you don't see your handle, it's because we are in brush sculpt mode. So right mouse button and select Translate Rotate Scale. Or you can hit the Y key. We can tweak the soft edit radius to give us a bigger influence. So we're done editing, we can turn off points display. And as always in Houdini, it's easy to just toggle on and off the changes you did. Just click on the bypass flag. And that's how you can edit points inside Houdini.